Gavin Hood, who previously directed X-Men Origins Wolverine, wrote the screenplay and directed Ender's Game.
You know, so many things in this book, written in 1985, are very much with us now. Blogging, tablets. I mean, there were these desk pad things in the book in 1985. Now we all use them. We all blog on the internet. Games, video games, and then the way video games have become war games, and war games have become real war games in the world of drone warfare. And using young people to play games, and yet in playing the game, they're actually flying real drones. So is it a game anymore, or is it real? I mean, it's incredible that in 1985, this book talked about all these things, and we're very much living with these themes and ideas today. And I'm sitting in the planetarium one day with my little twins, who were like 4 years old at the time, and my son in particular just loves the planets and space. So we go in, and I sit down, and I go, wait a minute, here's this huge, fantastic projector above my head that's switching on. And suddenly, in this black dome, I feel like I'm out in space. And everywhere I look, all around me, are stars in this three-dimensional way. Okay, so first of all, we're not going to play this game on a computer. We're going to create a huge environment to simulate this world. But how's he going to control that environment? And I forget when, but at some point I'm watching a concert at the Disney Concert Hall, and I'm with some friends, and here's this conductor like sweating up a storm. You know, you're over there and over there, and it's that's it. Ender is essentially the conductor of a giant video game, and we have to make this the coolest video game that we've ever seen. And if I stand Ender in the middle of a giant sphere and place his orchestra of warriors around him and allow him through gestural language to control that space in the way that you now control an iPad with sort of little, we do this, we think we're so cool. Well, what if I could zoom in? And we have the shot in Ender's Game, he zooms all the way in and zoom out and twist the world around and tilt it and do all these fabulous things that give us some spectacle in what is essentially a computer game. I'm tremendously proud of the work that the production designers Ben Proctor and Sean Harworth did on this film. Their attention to detail in the sets, and Peter Landau in the set decoration, and Christine Bislin-Clark in the costume design, and Don Milojevich in props, all of these folks paid a great deal of attention to detail. And there's moments, for example, when the kid stands in the shower and Ender got in the shower to shower, and wait a minute, there's a cake of soap hanging here from the props department that's actually got some writing about the International Fleet, and it's in a sort of shape of a star. We never see it in the movie. We never see that detail. But Ender felt the detail. Asa Butterfield felt that. The same was with the helmets. I mean, a tremendous amount of work went into these helmets. And they are particularly dear to me because we did have to persuade, and I hope my producers won't mind me saying this, but we had to do a lot of persuading of our producers to say, we really need these helmets to be brilliantly designed with visors that will perfectly curve to reflect the lights that are going to have to be practical in the set. You can't avoid reflections in a clear glass dome. They're going to be there. So the lighting design has to be brilliant. And the way that the lights above are divided into shapes. And if you look at the shots in the movie, when they're standing in the gate, for example, I'm really proud of those shots. Because when you look at Bonzo, for example, and he says, you, step aside. Have a look at the lighting in the helmet and watch how it looks like a sort of tribal set of lines in a frown mark. That's not by mistake. That's beautiful work done by the lighting department under Don McAlpine, with Steve Mathis, the gaffer, the production designers designing those lighting units, the way they look, the design of the helmets and the glass curves in them, right down to the fact that there are fans in the back of those helmets blowing air through the front so the actors don't mist up their helmets when they're talking. So much detail, so much care. And as I say, you know, you don't make a film on your own, and I had a phenomenal crew of people who really cared and really worked hard.
For more great Ender's Game content, go to ScreenSlam.com.